Okay, the center button. So those states that are colored purple are member states. And those member states can have unlimited numbers of weather stations joined into the network based on whatever grower in that state that wants to purchase a RainWise instrument and connect it to NEWA. Those that are gold, those are states where individual growers have contacted us and said, bless you, said that they want to be part of the NEWA network. And so they pay a different fee. The statewide membership fee is not very much. It's only $1,750 per year. That's $1,759. Okay, I got you on that. Everybody's listening. Okay, and that is not a question on the test either, all right? So this gives you a sense of our partnership. If this gets much bigger, we're gonna, you know, I'm gonna have to squish things down. But I wanted to show this because in Minnesota, the Minnesota Apple Growers Association pay the yearly membership fee. And in North Carolina, the North Carolina Apple Growers Association are paying that fee. And these people who are joining NEWA, I say, well, is it okay if a vegetable grower joins the network then? You know, I get a little nervous about that turf stuff. And they say, we don't care. We just want to be in and part of this because these models are really good. So the top three reasons, this might be on your exam, okay. IPM forecast tools for plant diseases and arthropods. Arthropods are insects and the spiders, you know, the arachnids and those things that have eight legs instead of six. Crop management tools, weather data, tables, and tools. NEWA is collecting data in real time. It's open access. You don't have to pay a fee to get this information. All the models run query-based, so you're putting in your information and what you want to know, and the answer is returned via the app. And so you can put in your first catch date, the green tip date in your orchard, that type of stuff. And basically, it's providing better IPM, reduced pesticide use, improved environmental protection, better crop management, improved crop quality, improved yield, and definitely enhanced decision support. In 2007, before we had launched our new website in 2009, we conducted a survey of apple, grape, potato, and onion growers in New York State. And we wanted to know what the impact of NEWA was on IPM. And when we asked those growers if NEWA helped them reduce sprays, improve spray timing, alert of pest risk, and enhance IPM, these were four separate questions, you can see how exciting we were to see that the vast majority agreed or strongly agreed. Where there was disagreement, usually there was a comment. So, you heard what Lori was saying about disease risk. And in a maritime climate, when there's a lot of humidity and moisture, or if it's a really rainy year like we have not had this year, you can end up applying more fungicides in your orchard to protect it from apple scab, not less. And so for those people who are savvy using these tools, they will realize that, Julie, in some years I'm going to be applying more sprays because it's a wet year and there's going to be greater risk of late blight of potato and tomato, or apple scab. So today, the exciting thing is that there are over 2 million page views per year of NEWA. That's 30 minutes that the end user is spending on a page of NEWA. That's what a page view is defined as. It's not just a hit. These are people that are actually spending time on the website, over 2 million. Growers in this survey in 2007, so these are 2015 data, growers can save on average $19,500 per year in spray costs. Or they also said how much they could prevent in crop loss. So for these high-value horticultural commodities like apples and grapes, potatoes, onion, on average, $250,000 per year that they can save in crop loss. And of those people who were NEWA end users, 99% would recommend using NEWA to other growers. This is a snapshot of what happens when you generate your presentation on a PC and they have a Mac in the audio visual world. So NEWA's homepage looks like this. This blue menu here follows you around the site and gives you access to weather data, pest forecasts, the station pages, crop management apps, and then this is about the weather stations, connecting them, which ones to buy, how to maintain them, and a troubleshooting guide. Oh, and interesting, those of you who are millennials know that if you go online now, wherever you are, they remember where you are. Ooh, creepy. We do that too. So we remember where you came in from, and we're going to center that map where you are. So we're creepy too. So these are the pest forecast items that we have. We have three apple disease models, about 8 or 9 apple insect models. We have a log of apple leaf wetness events. We have grape forecast models. We have an insect and 4 disease models for grapes, a cabbage maggot model. The onion models, the disease ones, are currently under review. And so these are being upgraded. Onion maggot model just got upgraded. We have late blight of potato and tomato, early blight. We also link to a Stewart's wilt of sweet corn risk map that is built based on winter temperatures and the survival of the leaf beetle that carries the bacterium that causes the disease. Alfalfa weevil, we link to a turf grass disease model that was built by the Northeast Regional Climate Center. And we also link to other pest forecast tools that are available outside of our menu. This is giving you a snapshot of the fire blight risk. And the reason I'm showing this is because this afternoon we're going to be talking about climate change. And you heard that on Suffolk County, one apple grower had never seen fire blight before. This is a bacterial disease that responds to heat and moisture, infects blossoms as they open. Chazy, New York is about as far north as you can get without being in Montreal, Canada. And they had really never seen fire blight much in the Champlain Valley until the last few years. A couple of things driving that: warmer temperatures, but also, how many of you love ginger gold gala? Yum. So a lot of our new modern cultivars that are in high demand in the marketplace are also highly susceptible to this disease. But this gives you a sense of what they were facing this year. So this is looking back at May 23rd, the grower, end user, can enter their first blossom open date in the orchard, hit calculate, and this is the risk level, high to extreme. This is the forecast data. Just to give you a perspective, how am I doing on time? Am I talking too much? I'm doing okay? All right. The crop management tools that we have, probably the biggest driver in terms of the popularity of NEWA right now is this thinning model that's been built by tree fruit physiologists at Cornell University and at the University of Massachusetts. Help me out, Dan, if I get anything wrong here. I think in any case, so a number of horticulturalists in the East have helped build and validate this model. And it has taken sort of the whole voodoo thing out of apple thinning. They really know what the carbohydrate balance of the tree is by using this model. This is a snapshot of how this model works. You'd enter the date of interest, so today's date, let's say. You'd put in the green tip date in the orchard, the bloom date in the orchard, and you'd hit the calculate button. This large chart is generated. The date of interest is this green row, the dates, historical dates, are in blue, and then it gives you the max min solar radiation and the tree carbohydrate status, the production, the demand, the balance, and the four-day average balance. Well, why is that important, Julie? Why would that be important to thinning? So all the apples you eat in the marketplace are being grown on a tree that has a cluster of blossoms that must have like 5-6 flowers on it. You really only want one of those fruit to develop for this apple to be big and yummy to eat. If the carbohydrate balance of the tree is low and its supply is low, it's not going to be able to carry all those fruit to term, right? Because it's not going to be able to feed them all. And so you're going to need less thinner to be applied in the orchard to drop those fruit off. And for an apple grower, that's that $250,000 of loss. Those are the people who are weighing in on that. Apples are extremely high value, high input crop. So if they overthin, they have no crop. If they underthin, they have little teeny apples that kids like to eat in the lunch box, but we don't really like, because we like everything big, you know, supersized. So this model has really revolutionized the utility of NEWA to the apple growing community. We also have weather products. Here, this yellow, this is, if you were scrolling down on your screen, this is how it would look when you selected something. It turns yellow. Our degree day calculator, we finally got back online, really nice. So we are tabulating degree days for all of these base temperatures. This is a high-low degree day. And we tabulate them accumulating from January 1st, March 1st, April 1st, and May 1st. And again, we also have the hourly data tables and the daily summaries. So why is this important and how can you use this? I was giving a talk in North Carolina and a grower came up to me and he goes, gosh, Julie, I had like 8 inches of rain in October and I couldn't get in to harvest my crop. It was devastating. So I said, oh, okay, let me show that to the group. And here's the daily summary. They are tabulated by month and you can see the rain on the 3rd, 3 inches of rain were collected by the rain gauge and measured. And in September, the end of September, the other like 3 or so inches were shown. And then the hourly data, you can see the rainfall. 1/3 of an inch, 1/4 of an inch per hour. 5 minutes, great. Here is a daily summary for what we're now calling the Valentine's Day Massacre that occurred this past winter. Yeah, that's what we're calling it. There's no peach crop, there's no sweet cherry crop, plums and other susceptible and delicate stone fruit whose fruit buds can only tolerate temperatures of a certain, you know, low level. So here it is. Look at this. This is the daily summary. And you can see the max temperature. Oh my gosh, do people remember how warm it was this winter? Yeah. And then Valentine's Day, when we're supposed to get even warmer and more snuggly, not happening because it dropped to like minus 10. And this is in Highland, New York, which is where the Hudson Valley Research Laboratory is located. And it was this cold snap. Then, of course, followed by the really warm March and then the April freeze, which really devastated the tree fruit industry in New York this year. So how can people use these NEWA tools? Obvious one, pesticide application timing. So you're protecting crops when sprays are necessary, and you're protecting the environment and your workers and the people eating your crops when those sprays aren't necessary. It can tell you when to set traps out for monitoring. Lori had the example of the apple maggot spheres. Those are traps that are used to monitor when apple maggots are emerging from the pupae that are in the ground, in the soil, and wanting to migrate into the orchard to, you know, that picture of the apple with the little worm coming out? Yeah, to infest the apple. When to scout for plant disease symptoms. The other big thing is documenting crop insurance. So now a grower can go back to NEWA and document that they've got this freeze damage or a disease outbreak that knocked their crop back, and they can hopefully collect some crop insurance. And then I didn't talk about this, but there is an apple irrigation timing model available. So this was what I learned from a millennial that just recently worked for me. I said, oh, you know, if we're going to add this to the website, should it open in a different window, you know, like in a different browser or tab? He said, you know, Julie, it doesn't really matter. I just keep these open on my smartphone, and I can scroll up and down on whatever browser window I want whenever I want. So here's our conference. Here's the Your NEWA blog, and then the degree day calculator, apple diseases, and the homepage. So it's easy. You just reload. You know? Oh, okay. I didn't know that. All right. So that's you know, pretty exciting. This is a snapshot of my phone, actually. So the future looks pretty bright for NEWA. It's pretty exciting. Betsy Lamb has secured a grant and is going to create, I think, how many? 70 zillions, zillions and zillions of woody ornamental insect degree day models. The New York Berry Growers Association got a grant, and we're going to be developing some insect and disease models for berry growers. I mentioned about the onion disease models, and then we're also looking at a way to cache the end user input. So if you input your green tip date once, you don't have to do it again and again. And with that, I'm done. So thank you so much.